Hi, I'm Erik, and I'm here at Eaton's Power System Experience Center with Ellie. Today, we'll be discussing how electricity moves throughout the house, starting with the utility meter socket, all the way down to your receptacles. We'll be addressing different questions that we get from homeowners and contractors, as well as suggesting solutions for many of these applications. Ellie, can I ask you some questions about meter sockets that I hear? Here's the first one. Meter socket compatibility seems to vary by state and by utility company. I moved to a new state recently with a new utility and my meter socket was different. How can I find out if a specific meter socket is approved by my utility company?
We've all been there, and it's not only states. Utility companies can vary between one suburb to another. This is the reason Eaton has relationships with national and regional utility companies, so we can ensure our meter sockets meet the requirements for installation before they get into the market. As you can see here, the ringless meter socket is very different than a bypass ring-style meter socket.
So how do I figure out which one of these should be used?
We already thought about that. To help you choose the right option, we developed a meter spec check tool where you can filter our products based on your utility and state requirements. An Eaton sales representative can also help find the right solution.
What if I have a unique installation need, such as lever bypass? Does Eaton have the right product for me?
Eaton has a wide range of meter sockets that includes sockets with different amperages, bypass styles, grounding locations, and cover types.
I have a single meter socket outside my home and the load center inside. Is that the only solution?
Well, that depends on the specific situation. A meter breaker can be a great option if you want to have your load center outside your house. It's combined with the meter socket. For some utilities, this is a more typical installation versus having the meter outside and the load center inside.
What about apartment complexes or high-rise buildings?
For those applications, landlords or building owners would use meter packs or group metering. As you can see, our metering line includes a broad range of solutions to fit your needs.
Lately, I've been hearing a lot about emergency disconnects for homes. What is that, and why is it important?
An emergency disconnect is a switch that is mounted outside a home that can shut off the power coming from the utility for the entire house in case of an emergency. It's designed specifically to help first responders.
Should I have one installed at my house?
Well, it depends where you live. You'll have to check whether the state you live in has adopted the requirement for the emergency disconnect from the National Electrical Code.
Does it require a specific device, or are there several solutions that can support this requirement?
You'll have to check your state requirements, but Eaton has several solutions that support the emergency disconnect requirement. For example, you can install an enclosed breaker, which is a service disconnect, outside the house with overcurrent protection. Or you can use an outdoor load center with a main breaker and move the service entrance load center outside. Alternatively, you can add an emergency disconnect switch outside the house, but still keep the main breaker for the panel inside the home for easier access. Other options are meter breakers and meter mains. Both combine the utility meter with the service disconnect and eliminate wiring between separate devices. The meter main feeds into a main lug panel inside the home, while the meter breaker feeds into a main lug subpanel.
Is Eaton developing any new solutions to help support the emergency disconnects?
Yes, we're working on expanding the meter mains and meter breakers to include an integrated surge solution, so we can offer our customers even more options.
With all the valuable electronics in our homes today, how and where should homeowners have contractors install surge protection?
Have you ever lost a TV, DVD player, computer, or other electronic device from an electrical storm? Or notice your lights flicker even when the weather is fine?
Sure. I sometimes lose power for a couple of seconds during lightning storms. One time my fridge stopped working. I had to replace the whole thing because it couldn't be repaired.
Well, you probably got hit by an electrical surge. A surge is a high voltage electrical disturbance that travels through the home's electrical distribution systems. It can damage electronics and appliances quickly. A surge protective device, or SPD, is designed to protect electrical devices from these spikes.
I see. After the storm, I added a whole home surge protector on my load center. I also plugged my TV into a surge protective receptacle.
That's great protection. Think about it this way. The surge protector on your main panel is designed to reduce the effects of large events and protect you in most cases. Surge receptacles are more localized and are designed to further reduce voltage from affecting the sensitive electronic equipment, such as computers and refrigerators, plugged into the outlet. Certain models also have LED indicators and audible alarms, so if the unit did fail, you would be notified the unit would need to be serviced.
I've replaced a few appliances in my home over the years. Do I have to buy a new surge protector every time I do that?
Good question. It depends on what kind of surge protector you have installed in the panel. They all have indication of function, but work like tires on your car. The more spikes they experience, the sooner they will wear out.
Now that I know that there are several types of surge protectors, how do I choose the right one?
Well, Erik, it depends. Surge modules are cost-effective and very easy to install. However, they take the place of a two-pole circuit breaker in the load center. If you don't have the space, you should consider a surge breaker, which is a circuit breaker with surge protection built into it. If you have expensive electronics or live in an area prone to surge events, like lightning strikes, you should consider a more robust whole home surge protector.
Wow, I wish I knew that before I lost my refrigerator. The first thing an electrician asks me when they come in to fix something is where's the electrical panel or load center? It sounds like a really important part of the home electrical system. Mine is located in the basement, flush mounted between two studs. I've also seen them surface mounted on the wall in a garage or utility closet.
For that reason, Eaton designed the plug-on neutral load centers with ease of installation in mind. Flush mount applications, we have drywall offset tabs that connect to the studs. Need to secure it to an existing wall? There is a keyhole feature. Need torque rating information? There's a sticker inside the load center.
How can one load center solution fit different needs?
It's all in the design. Different options for different scenarios. For example, our green bonding screw comes unthreaded, so you can thread it when you need to bond the ground and neutral, or remove it when you don't. Replace your gas dryer with an electric one and need additional breakers? There are optimized knockout locations and twist outs for additional access. All of these features make for quick, easy, and clean installations.
What if I decide to use alternative energy sources and install solar panels on my roof? Do you have a solution for me?
We have just the right solution for you. Our solar power centers combine both utility power and solar PV power into one enclosure. You may or may not know it, but you can't use a standard load center if you have a solar inverter installed, because you could theoretically have more than the bus rated current. Our solar ready load centers include factory installed permanent markings. That enables a quick and easy identification of product ratings and location of the parallel energy source disconnect as required by the National Electrical Code, to ensure your safety with bus ratings to accommodate the alternative energy source. You may think that the load center in your home is just something you need to have, but it's not. It can be so much more. If you select the right options for your load center, you can save time, save money, and help make your home much safer for you and your family.
It seems like I have many different breakers in my load center. Do they all perform the same functions?
No, actually, there are four types of breakers. Thermomagnetic breakers were historically the most common type. They can quickly limit short circuit current and thermal overloads to prevent fires. Ground fault circuit interrupters, also known as GFCIs, trip when they sense an imbalance between the outgoing and incoming current. They help protect people from an electric shock, most commonly when water is present. GFCIs trip quickly, even with low-level faults. You usually see them installed in kitchens and bathrooms. As we all hear in the news from time to time, electrical fires can occur if wires and cables are damaged, leading to arcing under certain conditions. The arc fault circuit interrupter, or AFCI, can identify potentially hazardous arcing situations and trip the breaker before an arc can start a fire. Dual function ground fault arc fault breakers, often referred to as AFGF breakers, are the cream of the crop. They offer protection from arc and ground faults for the entire circuit, including home runs from the breaker in your electric panel to a light switch or receptacle.
Are there any requirements specifying where to use each of these breakers?
Yes. The National Electrical Code requires that specific breakers be used in certain locations. For example, the code requires GFCI protection in areas around water or which are prone to moisture, like kitchens, bathrooms, laundry rooms, and outdoor areas. Arc fault breakers are appropriate for the rest of the living areas to prevent fires. Many code requirements combine both arc fault and ground fault in different areas of the home. Thermal magnetic breakers still have applications in bathrooms and basements when used in conjunction with a ground fault receptacle to comply with the code. We also see them used for many larger loads, such as air conditioners or electric ranges.
How can I differentiate all the different breakers in my load center?
That's the easy part in an Eaton load center. They are color-coded. Ground fault breakers have a white label, arc fault breakers are labeled green, and the dual function ones are labeled blue. Thermomagnetic breakers do not have color labels and typically have printing directly on the black plastic of the breaker.
I'm always looking for ways to save energy in my home. Does Eaton have any products that can help me?
Eaton provides a variety of lighting controls to save energy, one of them being the family of universal dimmers. These products use the latest in dimming technology to provide seamless, flicker-free dimming for today's most common lighting loads, including LEDs. With our family of universal dimmers, you can customize your lighting scenes while also saving energy.
Do these dimmers come in any different styles and colors?
The dimmers do come in multiple styles, from traditional toggle to decorator, and a variety of color options. So you can select the perfect dimmer to meet the decor of your home.
Besides dimmers, are there any other products that you would suggest?
Eaton offers a full suite of energy-saving devices. Dimmers, timers, and occupancy sensors are easy ways to incorporate energy savings into your home.
Great, who doesn't like saving on their energy bills nowadays? Contractors sometimes ask me about the latest options for plugging in new electronic devices in homes. Does Eaton offer anything to help with that?
Absolutely. These days, people are using smart devices to streamline their daily routines. But how often does it seem that every smart device in your home runs out of battery at the same time? That's why Eaton was the first to offer a tamper-resistant USB charging receptacle. These receptacles feature tamper-resistant shutters for safety and NEC compliance, while also featuring a USB charging port. With this product, you can eliminate bulky adapters while also improving charging times. The family of USB charging receptacles offer fast, convenient, and efficient charging of portable electronic devices such as smartphones and tablets.
That's great. But I have family members that have devices which require a Type A port charging and others that need a Type C port. Do we have anything which is versatile enough to cover both styles?
Yes. USB charging capabilities are constantly being upgraded due to technology advancements and consumers' requirements. Eaton offers multiple USB charging options, which include both Type A and Type C USB charging devices. For maximum flexibility and convenience, consider using a combination Type A and Type C port receptacle to charge your electronic devices regardless of the port type.
Now that I'm working from home more often, these USB receptacles would be a perfect addition to upgrade my home office. I could see my whole family benefiting from installing these devices throughout my home, so everyone's smart device is always charged and ready to go. Many people want to make their home smart to help simplify their lives. What smart home products does Eaton offer?
Eaton offers two types of solutions to help make your home smart. Our Wi-Fi smart devices connect to the home's Wi-Fi network and do not require a hub or controller. Our Z-Wave Plus wireless products do require use of a hub, and the devices communicate with each other in a mesh network. Whether your priority is a simple smart home solution or creating a larger home ecosystem, Eaton has products designed with reliability, ease of installation, and added convenience in mind.
What are the differences between using a Wi-Fi versus Z-Wave Plus system? And what are the advantages of each system?
Wi-Fi smart devices connect to the home's Wi-Fi network and offer users a frustration-free setup within the Amazon Alexa app, while a Z-Wave Plus system would connect to a compatible hub or controller and create a self-configuring mesh network. This means that devices communicate with each other as well as other Z-Wave Plus devices in a home, such as thermostats or door locks. This allows the user to create their own smart home ecosystem. Both of these technologies feature the ability to add voice and app-based control for added convenience.
How do I set up the Wi-Fi devices since I don't need a hub?
With Eaton's Wi-Fi smart devices, setup is simple and takes only three steps. First, use a qualified electrician to install your Wi-Fi smart device. Second, download the Amazon Alexa app. Third, open the Amazon Alexa app and follow the simple steps for a frustration-free setup of your devices.
Okay, so I have the device installed and set up within the Amazon Alexa app. What do I do next?
After the devices are set up, you can create lighting schedules and group devices to fit your daily routine. Additionally, you can also add voice control to your Wi-Fi smart devices using any Alexa built-in device. For the ultimate convenience, Eaton offers a Wi-Fi smart dimmer with Alexa built-in. This product offers the functionality of a dimmer with the convenience of Alexa all in one device, allowing you to effortlessly control lights while using the popular Amazon Alexa voice assistant platform.
What else can the Wi-Fi smart voice dimmer with Alexa built-in do?
You can ask Alexa to set a timer, play music, or make an announcement like, "Dinner's ready."
Wow, that's something my family would love to have installed in our home.
To learn more about all of the great electrical options for your home, contact a local Eaton representative or schedule a visit to one of our Power Systems Experience Centers today.